Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Today we have to discuss intensity of periodic sound waves. As we have already discussed the periodic sound waves, and we have discussed them as a pressure wave and as a displacement wave. So as we know, like in the case of stretched string, over there we have determined the energy transported by the transverse sinusoidal waves. A similar procedure we adopt over here to find out the energy transported by the sound waves. Consider a long tube which is filled with air with a piston at this end. This is a tube that is filled with air and this is a piston. Let this piston is oscillating at some frequency f or angular frequency omega, and as it oscillates it will push the air forward, and then when it comes back the rarefaction is produced, and due to its oscillations it transmits energy to the air in front of it, and that energy is carried by the sound wave in the direction in which it is propagating. So let us consider a small element of air having mass delta m, and the cross-sectional area, the cross-sectional area of this tube is say A, and the length of this element is delta x. So the volume of this element will apparently becomes A delta x. And what we have to do, we have to find the energy. So let us first evaluate the kinetic energy of this volume element. As we know that kinetic energy of a particle of mass m is half mv square, where v is its speed and m is the mass of the particle. Similarly, we here take an element, a fluid element or an air element in which there are a large number of particles, but we apply the equation kinetic energy is equal to half mv square to this whole element of mass delta m. So we know that its mass is delta m, and in terms of the density s will be equal to rho into delta v, or v the volume of this element, which is a delta x. So mass is known. There are three factors, half, m and v square. So m is known in terms of the density and the given dimension a and delta x, and we have to find v, the speed of the wave. The energy will be transported at the speed of, at the speed at which the wave is traveling, because these mass elements oscillate with the speed of the wave. So that is, the wave is propagating with this speed through these mass elements or through the air. So the energy will be transported at the speed of the wave. So now what is v of xt that we can find? Sorry, there is a confusion. The energy is transported at the speed that we can determine by this equation. So this is v of xt, speed of this element of the air is equal to the derivative of the displacement vector s of xt. As we have discussed, that s of xt is equal to x max, s maximum to cos kx minus omega t. Now If we differentiate it, this gives us omega s maximum into sine of kx minus omega t. So this is the speed of the wave. If we consider the speed of this wave at time t is equal to 0, and just if we take a snapshot of this element, that will give us v of xt at t is equal to 0 as omega s maximum into sine of kx. And the energy associated, the kinetic energy associated with this mass element comes out to be delta k half m. So instead of m, we write here delta m as the mass of the element of the air, delta m into v square. V we determined from this relation. So half delta m into omega s maximum into sine of kx whole square. At t is equal to 0, so this element, this term is 0 in this equation. So that comes out to be half rho a delta x. This rho is the density of the air, a delta x is volume. So delta m is equal to rho into volume into this v square, which comes out to be half rho a delta x into omega s maximum whole square. These two are constants, so omega s maximum whole square into sine square kx. This term oscillate with the position or with the x axis. Now this is the energy associated with a small arbitrary volume element. Now if we want to find out the energy in a volume element that has a length equal to the wavelength lambda, so we have to integrate this equation over one wavelength. So the kinetic energy associated with one wavelength long element will be equal to integral over dk, and this is 0 to lambda, and this is the value of dk or delta k, half rho a omega s maximum square into sine square kx dx. So these terms are constant, so we will get them out of the integral and we get the sine square kx dx. So this term, if we integrate it, this will give you 1 over 2 lambda. Whenever you integrate the sine square of some angle or cos square kx, so you have to split it by the identity sine square kx is equal to 1 minus 2 cos kx divided by 2. So the second term will give 0 and the first term gives you 1 over 2 lambda. So finally we get that the kinetic energy associated with one wavelength of the sound wave is 1 over 4 rho a omega s maximum whole square into lambda, where this rho is the density of the air in the tube, a is the cross-sectional area of the tube, omega is the angular frequency of the oscillating piston, and s maximum is the amplitude of the displacement, lambda is the wavelength. So if we look at the potential energy associated with this volume element, that also comes out to be the same as the kinetic energy. That is, the potential energy associated with one wavelength is also equal to this value. And if we find the total energy associated with one wavelength, that comes out to be the kinetic energy in one wavelength plus the potential energy in one wavelength. So just we have to double this relation. So the total energy associated with one wavelength comes out to be 1 over 2 rho a omega s maximum whole square into lambda. Now This we calculated at time t is equal to 0 in one wavelength. But if we are looking at a single point, that is a single value of x, then in how much time this much energy is transported. So in one time period of the wave, this much energy should pass a particular position. If we want to find out the power that is transported, we have to divide the energy divided by the time during which that energy is passing through a particular point. So the energy passing through a particular point is E lambda in a time interval equal to one time period. So this value divided by one time period will give you the power of the wave, and that comes out to be half rho v into a omega s maximum square. Okay, now we define the intensity. What is intensity? So the intensity is the power transmitted per unit area perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave, or the rate of energy transfer per unit area that is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave. I is equal to P divided by A, power transmitted through a unit area A that is perpendicular to the direction of propagation. If we take the area vector, then that comes out to be parallel to the direction of propagation. So if we use that equation of power and divide by A, we get half rho v into omega s maximum whole square. This is the intensity of the sound wave. If we use an equation, this equation is in term of the displacement, that is s maximum, the amplitude of the displacement, or in terms of the displacement wave. We can write it in terms of the pressure wave, that is how much is the maximum change in pressure. So that is related to the S maximum by this relation rho v omega S maximum is equal to delta P maximum. This is the maximum change in pressure, or the pressure amplitude, the maximum difference from the equilibrium pressure, or from the normal, or from the undisturbed pressure of the air in the tube. So that is equal to rho v omega S maximum. Rho v omega S maximum. So इसमें से एक rho v omega s maximum के बजाय हम use करते हैं delta p maximum. So if we adjust it like this, delta p maximum square, then we have to divide it by rho v, and half term 1 over 2 is over there already. So the intensity of a wave is equal to the square of the maximum pressure change divided by twice rho into v, where rho is the density of the air and v is the speed of the sound wave. Now here is an example about the hearing limits. So it says that the faintest sound that the human ear can detect at a frequency of 1000 hertz correspond to an intensity of about 1 into 10 to the power minus 12 watt per meter square. That is, if the sound has a frequency 1000 hertz, so its corresponding intensity will be like this, and this can be fairly heard by the sound. So this is also known as the threshold of hearing. The loudest sound the ear can tolerate at this frequency correspond to an intensity of 1 watt per meter square, the threshold of pain. So So determine the pressure amplitude and the displacement amplitude associated with these two limits. What we have to do over here, intensity is given, and we know the density of the air. So speed of the wave in the air is also known. So we have just to use the above given relation to find out the pressure amplitude and the displacement amplitude. So delta P maximum from the above equation comes to be 2 rho V into I under the root. So plug in the value. The density of air is this. Speed of the wave is 343 meter per second at the 20 degree centigrade. And I is the intensity that is given over here. So the threshold of hearing intensity is this, 10 to the power minus 12 watt per meter square. So the pressure amplitude corresponding to this intensity comes out to be 2.87 into 10 to the power minus 5 Newton per square meter or Pascal. We can calculate the corresponding displacement amplitude also by the above equation. Delta P maximum divided by rho V omega, plug in the values in this, that comes out to be S maximum is 1.1 into 10 to the power minus 11 meter. Okay, look at this. This S maximum is the displacement amplitude. It tells you how far a single particle can move from its equilibrium position when a wave passes through it. So every particle on the average can be displaced by a distance, maximum distance of this much when a wave, sound wave passes through the ear. So remarkably small number. If we compare this result for S maximum with the diameter of the molecule, about 10 to the power minus 10 meter, we see that the ear is an extremely sensitive detector of the sound wave. Why the story of ear is included over here? Because when the ear is disturbed by this much amount, every particle of the ear undergoes a simple harmonic oscillation with an amplitude of 1.11 into 10 to the power minus 11 meter, or we can say that it is 11 picometer, very small. So when this sound reaches your ear, that will displace the drum of the ear by this much amount, and we can detect that 11 picometer vibration via our ears. In similar manner, one finds the loudest sound that the human can hear or human ear can tolerate correspond to a pressure amplitude of this and displacement amplitude equal to this. Now, what is sound level? This was the absolute value of the intensity of the sound. The power per unit area, watt per meter square, was the unit of that. But now, those values have a very high power of 10, that is 10 to the power minus 11, 10 to the power minus 5. So it would be better that we should select a reference and will compare the intensities of all the other waves with that reference. So we set the reference to be the human hearing threshold, that is 1 into 10 to the power minus 12 watt per meter square, and that will correspond to a sound level of 0 decibel. And we will compare all the other values with that reference. So this formula is used to find the sound level. Beta is equal to 10 log of I over I naught, where I is the intensity of any sound wave, while this I naught is the intensity equal to 1 into 10 to the power minus 12 watt per meter square. Often in some books this beta is written as SL, means sound level. So F, we are going to find the sound level for the human hearing threshold I naught. So we will put I naught over here. So I naught over I naught is 1 and log of 1 is 0. So that corresponds to 0 decibel. Now F, we want to find the intensity of the threshold of the pen that was given in the above example. So that was 1 watt per meter square. So F, we want to find the sound level of the threshold of pen, that is 1 watt per meter square. So we have to plug in here as 1 watt per meter square and below 1 into 10 to the power minus 12 watt per meter square. All the rest of the things are cancelled out, but the 10 to the power minus 12 when goes to the numerator will become 10 to the power 12. And if we apply the log rule, so that 10 to the power 12, the power of the 10 can come over here, and the log of 10 will be 1. So 10 multiplied by 12 will be equal to 120. So the threshold of pen correspond to a sound level of 120 decibel, and the threshold of hearing comes to be 0 decibel, as already discussed. So this is how we determine the sound levels of various sounds. Here is an other example. There's two identical machines are positioned the same distance from a worker. यानी दो मशीन एक बंदे से एक जैसी डिस्टेंस पर है. The intensity of sound delivered by each machine at the location of the worker is this much. यानी जहाँ पे बंदा खड़ा है उसी पॉइंट पे हर एक मशीन से जो इंटेंसिटी वो डिटेक्ट कर सकता है वो इतना है. तो जब विदेश की ताकत मान पी 7 वाट पर मीटर स्क्वायर. Find the sound level heard by the worker when one machine is operating, and number B, when both the machines are operating. So we can determine the sound level at the location of the worker with one machine operating is calculated from the equation. Beta is equal to 10 log of I over I naught. So I is when one machine is operating, the intensity that the worker detects is for the one sound, so that is 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 watt per square meter, and divided by I naught. So this comes out to be like this, 53 decibel. Now when both the machines are operating, so apparently energy is carried from the sounds of the machines by the sounds of the machine to the ear of the worker, so the intensity will become doubled, that is 2 times this value. So that comes to be 4 into 10 to the power minus 7 watt per meter square. And the sound level in this case is given by 10 log of I over I naught. So I in this case is 4 into 10 to the power minus 7 divided by I naught. That comes out to be 56 decibel. From this result, what we see that if the intensity is doubled, the sound level increases by a value of 3 decibel. Thank you.